look at those individual things, can we now?
Yes, these, Judith, the essential to me, apart from having a nice custard, is to make sure that it's lovely and brown underneath. And these are baked in a tin, and I don't bake them blind. Mm. So I put the pastry and the filling and cook it together, which I think is the right way of doing it. If you bake them blind, it takes twice as long.
Mm. So that's what we're starting on, isn't it?
That's right. I'm going to do individual ones because I think it's rather nice. Or if you prefer, you can do one big one, about a seven inch. Mm. Roll the pastry thinly.
This is shortcrust pastry.
Yes, that's right. Mm. Shortcrust, that's using 4 ounces of plain flour and 2.5 ounces of fat.
And water, you said, I think, what, a teaspoonful?
A teaspoonful to the ounce of flour. The thing is, Judith, to not use too much water, because that's what makes hard pastry. So roll the pastry thinly and then cut it out slightly bigger than the top. Now, I've got a lovely lot of cutters here, but of course there isn't one just the right size, so I'm going to use the lid. Press it out. Now, if you haven't got any of these fancy cutters, you can easily use the a saucer or something like that.
Mm. And have you greased that little dish?
No need to grease dishes for pastry.
Oh. And you're actually pushing the...
Push it well down. You see, I've cut it a little bit bigger, Judith, and then press it into the side all the way around with your finger, pushing it into the edges.
Mm.
And then hands over the top, and you can just press off the surplus. If you're doing a big one, you can just roll the tin over, the rolling pin over.
Over the tin.
There we are. And to stop it rising in the middle, just a prick with a very sharp fork. That just stops it. So
that goes in the other five.
There
already.
We are. Just prick the bottom.
Mm.
And then the custard filling. Very easy. 2 eggs, 1/2 pint of milk. This is the basic recipe for all custards that have got to be set. 2 eggs, blended together with my cheap old whisk.
Famous whisk, yeah. And this is going to be cold custard, isn't it? I mean, you're using cold milk.
That's right.
To go into this. Oh.
If you used hot milk, the problem would be that the pastry would shrink down the sides of the tin. There we are. 1/2 pint of milk.
That looks lovely and creamy.
Well, and sugar, 1 ounce. Then, if you remember when you make scrambled egg, there's always a little bit of, or when you beat eggs, there's always a little bit of white.
Yes.
That, let's see if I can get this.
So you always sieve it, do you?
Always sieve it, because you get that little thread at the end, and it's not very nice to come across in the tart.
No, it certainly isn't.
There we are, Judith. You see there's just one or two pieces in the bottom,
mm.
and it's best to get them out.
Mm.
There we are.
It amazes me that that doesn't sort of all disintegrate, because it's all uncooked pastry, isn't it?
Uncooked pastry. Now, you may see in some recipes that you're to cook them blind. I find it totally unnecessary, and it takes a lot of time, and you've got to watch them. Mm. You know, to bake blind is to put grease proof in the middle and beans or crumpled foil, and I don't find it necessary at all.
The marvellous thing about all these recipes today is that they're, apart perhaps from the trifle which we're doing last, is that it's so economical, because custard itself is very economical to make, isn't it?
Well, it is at the moment. Eggs are, this week and the end of this week, they're going to be down 3 pence for a standard dozen. So
that's nutmeg.
That's right, grated nutmeg. Much nicer and keeps much longer if you buy whole nutmeg.
Does it?
Mm. There we are. Now, the secret of that getting the bottom brown is, one, it stops it spilling on the oven, that's another great joy, is to heat up in the oven a tin at 400 degrees Fahrenheit, gas number 6, heat it up so it's absolutely boiling, so that when this comes in contact with the tin, it will become beautifully brown underneath.
And there's heat there ready waiting for it, sort of thing, already.
There we are. Judith, I'm going to need somebody to pull the oven door open for me. Lovely. You need a steady hand, we don't want to spill them. And this has got a drop-down door, and I'll come round the side.
Okay.
And there's the tin in the oven, and the moment that touches, it will begin to cook underneath.
How long do you leave those in for, Mary?
It will vary very much, but start it off at 400 for about 10 or 15 minutes and then lower the oven temperature for a little bit longer until the custard is set and the pastry pale brown. Mm. Now, in a metal tin, there's no need to bake blind, but if you use one of those lovely china dishes, you'll find you should bake blind, because otherwise you'll find that it will be rather pale underneath, because china's a bad conductor of heat.
Whereas those tins are very good conductors.
Very good indeed, yes.